Checkpoint Theatre presents Vulnerable, written and performed by Cheyenne Alexandria Phillips, dramaturged and directed by Huzir Sulaiman, with music and sound design by Shah Tahir. 2. The Setup.
We are going to have a support group. In all the time I've known her, I've never seen my middle-aged cardiologist so excited about anything before. You didn't come for the last one. I went clubbing the night before. I wasn't gonna tell her that. I thought it was a stupid idea, to be honest. Something she concocted the year John Green's The Fault in Our Stars came out. I wasn't gonna tell her that either. I definitely was not going to admit I cried when I read the book, and again when I watched the movie. And while I don't have cancer, I know the rhythm in my chest takes a countdown of inevitability. I sit in her office every 6 months, pay the hospital a sum, to tell me the inevitable has yet to come, like I didn't already know that. I don't tell her this. I tell her I will come down on the assigned Saturday. I will show support. Whatever that means. How to become a tour guide just before the pandemic. Part 1. I don't know how one becomes a tour guide in other parts of the world, but in Singapore you need to be licensed. People have asked, why get licensed when you already know how to give a tour? So that I don't get arrested. Really, it is so I don't get a huge fine and get blacklisted by Singapore Tourism Board. So I had to be licensed. It takes about 9 months, if you're lucky. Like having a baby. You put yourself through all the hell and hope all goes well. At the orientation session, they scare you. Guests can be very difficult. You must know everything about Singapore. It's subsidized, but if you quit, you have to pay everything back. This is how they weed out the weak. Or the truly wise. They set the expectations that this will be worse than hell. Those who are strong, or stupid, or outrightly stubborn pay for the course fees then and there. I don't know which of the three S's I am. As the youngest in the class, I become the sacrificial lamb. They make me class monitor. Fine, I will support all these aunties and uncles. You start classes and you realize how much material they don't give you. You have to start studying immediately, from day one. When did Singapore gain independence? 9 August 1965. On what day did Sir Stamford Raffles step onto Singapore? Trick question. He arrived at St. John's on the 28th of January, 1819, quarantined overnight, and stepped onto the bank of Singapore River the next day. What did the 5 stars on the Singapore flag represent? Remember the acronym JDEP. Justice, democracy, equality, progress, and peace, not prosperity. The flag is everywhere. You will be killed with death glares if you don't know what the 5 stars represent. Aunties and uncles say that it's too much information for them. They cannot learn everything. Ah, but they must! You do the online learning, which is not sufficient to tell you everything. So you have to self-study. You know for a fact that the sections on the live animal park and sister attractions are severely lacking. The bulk of it is outdated. So you have to correct your learning provider's information. You go through a total of 5 modules. 1 theory, 3 in customer service, because tourists can be so challenging that you need 3 modules to help you. And the final one is a practical module. If you fail a module, you have to redo it. And even though you might be doing a customer service module, the trainers will still test you. Let's say you are passing by the Istana. Okay, imagine. You are standing in front of the bus, and you face the guests, and you say, "We are going to pass by the Istana," and they don't see the Istana, and they complain. What went wrong? What should you have said? Answer: you should have said you can see the gates of the Istana. No one can see the Istana from the road. At least when you say the gates and the guest sees the gates, you aren't in the wrong. Let's say it all goes well and you pass all the four earlier modules and you put yourself through 7 months of pain, sweat and tears. Now comes the worst part of any pregnancy, the last trimester, aka the on-site practice. You have to prepare 2 pre-assigned routes that you will practice and receive soul-crushing feedback on. The feedback can be very painful, because what you thought was important turns out to be completely useless information. Worse still, there are usually 3 sites per route, 2 routes to practice over the weekend, a total of 6 locations to cram into your head over the week. That's a lot of ways to fail. You constantly study. When did the National Gallery open? What are Singapore's 4 taps? How many official religions are there in Singapore? Why is the Esplanade called the People's Theatre? You will never know everything. Never. Never, ever, ever. You can try, but then the trainer will point to something and say, "What's this?" Sometimes it's just to test you, to see how you do under pressure. If you know the answer, then great. If you don't, you acknowledge that maybe it's lost somewhere in your brain, and you are sure it will come back to you if the guest allows for some time for your brain fart to end. Don't say, "I don't know." You are the guide. You are supposed to know. Somewhere amidst all of the knowledge, you must include stories, jokes, and an event to cross-promote. I worked really hard on some of my jokes. I would say, "Oh, I'm Eurasian. I have mixed European and Asian ancestry." Eurasians only make up 0.03% of the population, about 17,000 people in a national population of 5.7 million. You need to randomly meet 335 people before you run into one Eurasian person. Don't worry, you don't need to go looking. I'm right here. Anytime the bus drove over reclaimed land, my main joke was, in the past, all of this used to be ocean. So if you want, you can imagine the bus as a ship. You build all this repertoire. You get shot down a lot. There are too many horror stories. Some include me. Some include classmates who tried to work on personality alone and did not prepare any information. Some include classmates with questionable sources who share information everyone knows to be untrue. You study as much as you can. You try and find as many credible sources as you can. You pester family members for stories about the past that you can tell visitors. Then you schedule the final exam. I failed my first round. Chinatown, around Mid-Autumn Festival. Telling the story of Chang'e and how she became the moon goddess and why we eat mooncakes during this time. As one of the 2 non-Chinese candidates, it was no surprise I got Chinatown. No surprise. I went super prepared, right? But apparently my Chang'e story was wrong. It's a legend. It's got so many different versions. How can it be wrong? I found 2 different versions and picked the one that was more romantic. I didn't know that legends could be wrong. When you are informed that you failed, it's devastating. Sorry, the phrase they use is, "You are not yet competent." I know what they're trying to get at here, but we all know that these words are just a disguise for an actual fact. You failed. It hit harder because Mid-Autumn fell on my birthday in 2019. I even told the joke that I could get mooncake as my birthday cake that year. Happy birthday, Cheyenne. The support group. I am in the hospital on a Saturday morning. Apparently at the support group meeting that takes place every 3 years. For some reason. After the initial talks and thank yous, we split up into respective age groups. Our plus ones are in a group on their own. My group is made up of only women of what my cardiologist likes to call childbearing age. She got us together to plan our pregnancies, like some weird sisterhood pact. Not exactly. She doesn't want us to have overlapping third trimesters. She says she wants to be able to schedule holidays. She has her head nurse lead this group of childbearing age women. The first question that is asked is, so, can we go skydiving? I don't regret coming now. Soon we make plans to go skydiving together, like some weird sisterhood pact. We were scheduling our holidays. We invited our cardiologist. Now we can go on holiday together, we told her. That was not what she wanted to hear. How to become a tour guide just before the pandemic, part 2. My new test date is in January 2020. I clear my schedule for late December and early January to study everything. Everything. I do not have a clue where I'm going yet, but I know that Chinese New Year and Pongal are happening around the same time as my tests, so I study major festivals first. I cover key demographics, I go down and visit all the cultural sites, especially Chinatown. I might not be Chinese, but this was going to be my new favorite place. I meet up with the other candidates, all of them Chinese uncles. I learned that we are either getting West Coast or cultural sites. It's like I'm back in secondary school, betting on which chapters will come out for the final exam. I'm sure it will be cultural sites, and I will get Chinatown. The truth is, we don't know. We don't have a clue. You cannot bet on these things because you could be tested anywhere. My gut is right. We get cultural sites. There are 2 festivals happening. It was highly unlikely we weren't going there. On the bus, I introduce myself, set the logistics for the tour, wish everyone a pleasant stay, even though everyone on the bus is Singaporean. I get lucky here because I am passing by the gates of the Istana. It happens that during Chinese New Year, the gates of the Istana would open for you to visit the open day. But from the bus, remember, you can see the gates, not the building. 2 other candidates are tested in Little India. There's so much symbolism to talk about. Very interesting, but very intense. Peacock feather means this. Mango leaf means something else. What does Pongal represent? What goes into making those really sweet desserts? Me? I watched cooking videos. I could recite recipes if needed. But I get Chinatown. Again. No surprise. Again. It's Chinese New Year. I tell the story of how it is the year of the rat. I list all the snacks people like to eat at Chinese New Year and the meaning behind them. Want more kids? Eat more sunflower seeds. I have a brain fart when asked where to get bakwa. Brain fart! But I can point you in the direction of a popular store. I am tested to see if I know how to handle the question, does Singapore have homeless people? Off the record, they asked me what food is not eaten in the new year. I didn't know that it was mooncake. On the bus back to Tourism Board HQ, I'm shaking and I am nervous. I am not convinced it was enough. I go in for my results, expecting to be bruised. Turns out they are impressed. I shared important details about the Zodiac story. I managed to answer the homeless person question smoothly. I know what most of the snacks mean. I know the Istana gates only open on special occasions. I am competent now. 16 January 2020. I am competent now. It took almost 18 months. I could have had 2 pregnancies. It's an incredible achievement. It'll be hard not to acknowledge that. But 7 days after I was found competent, the first case of COVID-19 was found in Singapore on 23rd January 2020. It felt like 18 months of effort became obsolete. A false start. I collect my license a month later. Receiving it feels like being gifted a white elephant. What am I supposed to do with this now?
Vulnerable is developed and produced by Checkpoint Theatre. To support the creation of original Singapore work, please make a donation to Checkpoint Theatre at www.giving.sg. Checkpoint Theatre's Vulnerable, produced by Huzir Sulaiman and Claire Wong, written and performed by Cheyenne Alexandria Phillips, dramaturged and directed by Huzir Sulaiman, sound engineering, music and sound design by Shah Tahir, production stage manager is Sumono, assistant dramaturg Mal Yen Tay, marketing and publicity by Lum Ishawn and Jane Lim, additional support by Nicole Wong. If you have the time, we would love to hear from you. Please give us your feedback by following the link in this episode's description.